For the past 100 years, refrigeration has worked basically the same way. Liquid absorbs heat, turns into gas, and is compressed into a liquid and starts over again, as we can see in this explainer video that first aired on the BBC Channel 4 in 1988.
It had been discovered that various gases, when they're compressed, can condense into liquids. The cooling effect is quite dramatic.
We've changed the efficiency and the scale of our refrigerators, but all commercial refrigeration is the same process. Except that this process is still inefficient, and the gases we use to heat and cool are greenhouse gases, far worse for global warming than carbon dioxide. A report from the Rocky Mountain Institute predicts that the number of air conditioners to increase 4 times over in the next 30 years because of global warming, 5 times over in emerging economies. These air conditioners will have those same greenhouse gases. Researchers at Ames Lab are working on that.
My name is Vitalij Pecharsky, and I'm a scientist at Ames Laboratory. I also am a professor at the Department of Material Science and Engineering at Iowa State University. There are things called caloric materials that change their temperature based on different kinds of force: magnetic, electrical, or mechanical. In more concrete terms, that means when a material is passed by a magnet, zapped by electricity, stretched or compressed, it heats up or cools down. No greenhouse gases required. In fact, using caloric materials may be a third more efficient than vapor compression systems in use today. The laboratory is also focusing on devices and systems that can use those materials in everyday settings.
But how does it work? Caloric materials rely on entropy changes. Entropy is the measure of disorder that all physical material have, and it can be thought of as related to heat. Think of an ice cube. A frozen ice cube is rigid. It has molecules trapped in their locations and not moving very much. As heat is absorbed, the ice melts and turns into a very disorderly water. This is how caloric materials can be used in refrigeration. If they can absorb heat from their surroundings by being demagnetized, relaxed after being squeezed, or when moved from an electrical current, just like a melting ice cube, this can remove the need for compressed gases. And if they can operate with only minimal changes of one of the three different forces, magnetic, electrical, or mechanical, this makes them even more energy efficient. In fact, nearly as efficient as those wooden fridges we saw in the beginning. Ames Lab is working on that design. The work done here will likely not be seen in stores for years, but the science will help us create a more sustainable future.